शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ब्रह्माणु विदाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तहुं देवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धिर्विकेतनं पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परमहः तदेवाहमिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। Continuing in the fourth chapter, looked at the different types of chaitanyas divided by name. So looked at the pramatru chaitanya, pramana chaitanya, pramiti chaitanya, and prameya chaitanya. Then we looked at the lakshanas of each. And while looking at that, we also looked at the definition of Visheshana and Upadhi. So Antakarana Vishishta Chaitanya is Jiva, who is called as Pramata, whereas Sakshi is Antakarana Upahita Chaitanya. Antakarana Upahita Chaitanya is Sakshi. And then once we said Vishishta and Upahita, they also have to be defined. The words have to be understood. So, Visheshya here, Visheshya, Visheshan and Visheshya are being defined. There, we looked at Visheshana definition and moving on to Upadhi Lakshana. We are looking at Upadhi Lakshana. What is Upadhi? That which does not have anvaya with the vastu. Visheshana is that which has anvaya with the vastu. It's an existent thing, vidyamanam, and then it has an anvaya, so anvita, and also there is pravesha. Pravesha is sambandha. Whereas upadhi is what? Yastu. So to contrast it, karyanvyat. Karya anvayetve sati vyavartakatve sati vidyamanatvam visheshanasya lakshanam. Yeah, vyavartakatvam. So vyavartakatvam is there in both cases. There is vyavartakatvam in visheshana as well as upadhi. Vidyamanatvam, obviously it is there because it has to be existent. So that which is existent and differentiates from the other can be a visheshana also. It can be an upadhi also. If it has an anvaya with the karya, with its product, with the, not its product, with the product of the karana, then it is visheshana. If it does not have an anvaya, then it is an upadhi. So yastu vastu swarupe antarene eva pravesham vyavartako bhavati sa upadhi rityuchyate. So vidyamanatvam is understood there. Pravesham vina. So antarena pravesham means pravesham vina. And pravesha, we saw the tippanakara mentioned as sambandha. So karya ananvyetve sati vyavartakatve sati vidyamanatvam upadhi lakshanam. And in Nayayika Mata, we saw the shrotra as the example where akasha has no sambandha. Rather, other way around. We should look at the other way around because we are defining the upadhi. So upadhi has no sambandha with the vastu. Vastu being akasha, there is no anvaya, there is no pravesha of the karna shushkali. Karna, so Karna Shashkuli is the ear lobe or the golaka. It does not have any anvaya with the nabha or akasha, which is there in the, which is outside and inside. But then we divide, it differentiates the akasha, which is within the Karna Golaka, from that which is outside the Karna Golaka. So it has vyavartakattvam. So being vidyamana has vyavartakattvam, and while differentiating, it does not have an anvaya with the akasha. So that was the example we looked at. So ghatakasha, tasmat karana golakam vyavartakam bhavati. So karana golaka is a vyavartaka. Why? Because it differentiates the akasha within itself, karana golaka, without connecting, it differentiates. Therefore, not only is it a vyavartaka, but it is an upadhi. Ghatakasha prastha parimitannasya avakasham dadati ityatra ghataha akashasya upadhi reva. So to drive home this point of Karna Golaka in the Nayayika Mata, using the Nayayika Mate, so using the well-established in Nyaya, we took that example. Now another example is taken, Ghatakasha Matakasha, which is a good example in Avachedavada for Vedanti. So Vedanti say that Ghatakasha, in the example of Ghatakasha, Akasha is differentiated. Which Akasha? The Akasha which is, so to say, contained in Ghata. That is differentiated by the Ghata. So Vyavartakattvam is there. Obviously, Ghata is Vidyamana. So Vidyamanatvam is there. So Vidyamanatvesati, Vyavartakatvesati. Now, does it have Karya Anvaya or not? So Ghatakasha, Ghata has no Anvaya with the Akasha. It differentiates the Mahakasha as contained in the pot, in Ghata, as Ghatakasha. Therefore, it does not have Anvaya. It has nothing to do with the space. Ghata is in space. Before Ghata came about, space was there. While it is coming about, there is space in the boundary of the Ghata, and there is space within. So Akasha is outside, through and through Ghata, and within also. So Ghata has no connection at all, no Pravesha, no Anvaya with Akasha at all, but still it serves the purpose of differentiating by at least name, if nothing by name. And for Vyavahara, we can use that name and then have different kind of sentences or Vyavahara. Therefore, one Ghatakasha can be differentiated from another also, but initially, it is differentiated from Mahakasha. So, Ghatakasha prastha parimitannasya avakasham dadati. In this sentence, dadati gives, Ghatakasha gives avakasha. Because Akasha, what is the Akasha Lakshana? Akasha Lakshana, simple Lakshana of Akasha is avakasha pradatru Akasha. Or Akasham. Akasha takes both genders. It can be Pullinge as well as Napunsakalinge. So Avakasham Dadati. Akasha is that which, literal translation, which gives an opportunity for something to happen. Now here, Akashaha Avakasham Dadati. It gives Avakasha. For what? Prastha Parimita Anna. Prastha Parimita Annasya. So it gives Akasha to Prastha Parimita Anna. Parimita is from Ma Mane Dhatu. So it is measured. What is the measure there? It is Prastha. Prastha is some kind of a unit like Drona. There are some measure units in Sanskrita. So you can take a modern example. Some kind of a, say, few kgs of rice. Anna, we can take as rice, any amount of rice can be contained in a particular size of the ghata. But is ghata really giving the avakasha to anna, or is akasha giving the avakasha to anna? It can't be ghata, because without the ghata also we can still put the anna there in space. Their ground is still there, so there is no necessity of ghata for anna to be there. What is necessary is akasha. That akasha may or may not be contained by a boundary. It is irrelevant for the akasha to have avakasha pradatrutvam. But in the sentence ghata akasha prastha parimitannasya avakasham dadati, there only a particular measure can be contained in a particular space. To have more anna, you'll have to break the pot. So the pot is helping you differentiate the space which can contain only so much rice. Therefore, for vyavahara, we have to say ghatakasha is giving the avakasha, not akasha, ghatakasha. Akasha definitely, but what kind of akasha? Ghatakasha. Because it can contain only so much rice. So in that sentence, ghatakasha prastha parimita annasya avakasham dadati ityatra, in that sentence, ghata akashasya upadhi reva, is ghata, in ghatakasha sabda, ghata, is it a visheshana to akasha or an upadhi? There upadhi reva. Why? Prastha parimita anna avakasha datra akasha swarupe pravesham vina eva ghata महाकाशाद विभज्य घटाकाशम बोधयति. सो व्हाट कैन कंटेन अ फ्यू केजेस ऑफ राइस? लेट्स से यू कैन टेक अ स्पेसिफिक मेजर, ओनली से 2.3 केजेस ऑफ राइस. एक्चुअली इट इज वॉल्यूम दैट इज बीइंग कंटेन्ड, बट देन विल मेजर एज, सो यू कैन से इट्स अ मेजर, इट कैन बी अ फ्यू केजेस एज वी अंडरस्टैंड, बट इट्स अ वॉल्यूम एक्चुअली दैट द स्पेस इज गोइंग टू कंटेन देयर. Because rice can be replaced by something else, and that many kgs may not fit in. So it's actually a volume. So whatever volume is being contained, that is very specific to that akasha within the ghata. Therefore, from mahakasha, ghatakasha, ghata is definitely helping differentiate the ghatakasha. Very specific to that measure. Therefore, prastha parimita anna avakasha datra akasha. That akasha which is giving avakasha for anna to be there, which is a particular measure of prastha, prastha paramita. And unto that akasha swarupa, akasha swarupe, pravesham vina, there is no connection of ghata, but still it differentiates. Therefore, ghata mahakashad vibhajya, having differentiated from mahakasha, it is revealing a particular space which is ghatakasha. So ghatakasham bodhayati. Therefore, what? Ghataha akashasya upadireva natu visheshanam. Ghatasya prithvikaryatve, ghatasya prithvikaryatvena avakasha pradatva sambhavat akasha swarupe pravesho na yujyate. Why do you say there is no pravesha sambandha of ghata with the akasha? Because ghata is prithvikarya. Being prithvikarya, akasha precedes that. It cannot have any avakasha pradatuttvam. Avakasha pradatuttvam is only for akasha, which precedes the prithvi also. Therefore, due to the impossibility of prithvikarya ghata to give avakasha to anything else, आकाश स्वरूपे प्रवेशो न युज्यते तस्माद् घटः आकाशस्य उपाधिरेव. सो घटाकाश, ऑल्दो घटाकाश इज रिवील्ड, स्टिल इट इज विदाउट कनेक्शन विद आकाश बाय घट. एवं अंतकरण, सिमिलरली इन दी एग्जाम्प्लीफाइड, एवं अंतकरण उपहित चैतन्यम साक्षी इत्यत्र साक्षिणो अंतकरण उपाधि. इन द डेफिनेशन, अंतकरण उपहित चैतन्य इज साक्षी. दे साक्षिणः अंतकरणम उपाधि. फॉर साक्षी अंतकरण इज उपाधि. व्हाई? बिकॉज इट डिफरेंशिएट्स अ पर्टिकुलर चैतन्य from the general term Chaitanya without having any anvaya or pravesha or sambandha with Chaitanya. Chaitanya is Niravayavi. With a Niravayavi, there cannot be any sambandha. Nahi antakkarnasya sakshi swarupe pravesho bhavati. In the sakshi swarupa, there is no pravesha sambandha of antakkarna. But still, antakkarna reveals a particular kind of particularized, individualized chaitanya. Kintu antakkarnam prameya chaitanyad vibhajya sakshinam bodhayati. In the context of subject-object division, there pramata is different from prameya. Therefore, subject being different from object, there is nothing but chaitanya, but still we have subject-object division. So in that case, subject with a visheshana of the subject, pramata, chaitanya is differentiated. And with the visheshana of the prameya, chaitanya is differentiated. So you have subject-object division. Now, in the level of chaitanya also, we have subject-object division. There, they are visheshanas. They have sambandha with chaitanya. What kind of sambandha? Adhyasika sambandha. But still, there is a sambandha. Where there is no sambandha, where we can see that there is no sambandha, there is no tadatmya bhava, there, the pramata is no longer pramata, he is a sakshi. So that is the difference between pramata and sakshi. So when you look at sakshi, then chaitanya is differentiated from prameya chaitanya, but not as pramata, but as sakshi, because we know that tadatmya sambandha itself, be it adhyastha, adhyasika sambandha, is not possible. Adhyasika sambandha is possible due to avidya, but still when you inquire, vicharam na sahate. Avidya vicharam na sahate. So if you inquire into it, then pramata ceases to be pramata, becomes a sakshi. Visheshana drops off because you know that I cannot have a visheshana because of pravesha not being possible in my swarupa. There cannot be any sambandha. Therefore, I am a sakshi, and sakshi is what? Sakshi Chaitanya, which we have seen earlier as sakshi, although individualized, is individualized only by name, but there is no real division. It is same as Brahma Chaitanya. Kintu antakkarnam prameya chaitanyad vibhajya sakshinam bodhayati. Tasmad ekameva antakkarnam sakshinaha upadityena pramatuhu visheshanatvena cha bhavati. The same antakkarana is a visheshana for pramata and is an upadhi for sakshi. Antakkarana upahita chaitanyam sakshi. That is the lakshana of sakshi now. So what is upahita now? That is also to be looked into. Antakkarana visishta chaitanyam pramata. This is lakshana of pramatru or pramata. So Vishishta, that is Antakkarana Vino, Chaitanya Vino, Upahita has been used, not defined per se, and Antakkarana Vishishta Chaitanyam, again here also Antakkarana Vino, Chaitanya Vino, Vishishta has scope for definition rather, although it is known. But Upahita may be a little tricky to understand. Vishishta is known, Ta Pratyanta, Upahita also Ta Pratyanta. But to explain further, even that is clarified by sadhu, upadina yuktam upahitam iti visheshanena yuktam visishtam iti cha uchyate. So the definitions vyutpatyartha is explained as what? Upahita means upadina yuktam. Upadina yuktam upahitam. That which is endowed with an upadhi is called as upahita. Therefore, antakkarana upahita chaitanya means what? Chaitanya which is endowed with antakkarana as what? Upadhi. Endowed with the upadhi of antakkarana. चैतन्य विच इज एंडोर्ड विद द उपाधि ऑफ अंतकरण इज साक्षी इति दिस इज द डेफिनेशन वेर एज विशेषणेन युक्तम विशिष्टम इति च उच्यते व्हाट इज विशिष्ट विशिष्ट इज आल्सो युक्तम एंडोर्ड बट विशिष्ट मीन्स एंडोर्ड विद विशेषण सो इन द डेफिनेशन अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्यम प्रमाता प्रमाता इज चैतन्य हू इज एंडोर्ड विद अ विशेषण ऑफ अंतकरण We have seen this, but it is still clarified in as many words. Tatra antakarana vishishta pramata eva karta bhokta ityadi. So who is the karta bhokta? It is not sakshi. Karta bhokta manta ityadi sukhi dukhi all that is antakarana vishishta चैतन्य हु इज कॉल्ड एज प्रमाता दैट प्रमाता अलोन इज कर्ता भोक्ता सुखी दुखी संसारी जीव भवती वेर एज साक्षी इज नॉट जीव इज नॉट अ संसारी इज नॉट सुखी दुखी इज नॉट कर्ता भोक्ता इत्थम अवच्छेद वादरीत्या प्रमात्रादि लक्षणं निरूपितम् सो फॉर व्हाट हैज बीन एक्सप्लेन्ड इज The definition of pramata ityadi, pramata, sakshi, as per the avachedavada. Avachedavada is used by Bhamatikara. Bhagavan Bhashyakara mentions it, but then it is not really used as a vada. It is used as an explanation, which may be sufficient in some cases. Nothing wrong in holding on to that explanation, but if you inquire deeper, some other questions may pop up. No vada is complete in itself. Any vada which resolves your doubt is a valid vada. It should resolve your doubt while not contradicting or taking away the siddhanta of Advaita. As long as that aspect is met, any vada is okay. However, if you inquire more and more questions pop up which are not answerable, which are not convincing, even with tikas, then you can switch vadas. Whichever vada will clarify your doubts, that is what one should hold on to. We need not go and debate out saying that the other is wrong. It's good to know the pros and cons of each vada, but they are just for debate and just as an intellectual exercise to sharpen your brain. Sharpen your understanding, the intellect, so that it becomes, capable to understand the subtlety the more we study at the tika level, etc. But if it is convincing enough to not contradict the aikya and we don't have doubts, if others bring questions, we need not be able to answer them, but at least we should not own up their doubts. We should not start doubting the siddhanta itself. Or, how can this vada be right? As long as that doesn't happen, it is okay. But still, we have to understand pramata in other vada also. Pramata adi lakshana in other vada. Why so? Because if at all, avachheda vada is not that convincing, or even to know, what kind of issues can be there, we have to know more. So, broader perspective is better. So that you can pick and choose. Abhasa vada ritya jiva sakshino swarupam. It is also another reason why this has to be studied is because based on the grantha that you study, there can be multiple perspectives. To understand those perspectives also, we need to understand which vada is the Puropakshi or the Siddhanti is coming from. So abhasa vada ritya jiva sakshino swarupam. What is the swarupa of jiva? What is the swarupa of sakshi? As per Abhasavada. Abhasavada is introduced by Panchapadikara. So, it is followed by Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya also in Viveka Chudamani. Panchadashi. Panchadashi. आभासवादे आभास सहित अंतकरण जीवस्य विशेषणम् व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ Sakshi Swarupa and Jiva Swarupa. So there Abhasavadi, in Abhasavada, Abhasa Saita Antakkaranam, Jivasya Visheshanam. So Visheshana is there in the earlier Paksha also, in the earlier Vada. But here, Abhasa Saita Antakkaranam, not Antakkarana Jivasya Visheshanam, Jiva being Chaitanya. So Chaitanya, which has Antakkarana as the Visheshana, that is common across both Vadas. However, Abhasa Sahita Antakkarana is a specific difference, not a general Antakkarana, an Antakkarana which is Abhasa Sahita. Thereby, Abhasa Sahita Antakkaranam Jivasya Visheshanam Sakshina Upadischa Bhavati. And Upadi for Sakshi is also same. In the definition, for Sakshi, Antakkarana is an Upadi. And for Jiva or Pramata, Antakkarana is a Visheshan. This is common across both Vadas. But what kind of Antakkarana? Here there is a granularity in Abhasa Vada which says that Antakkarana has to be known as Abhasa Sahita Antakkarana. It cannot be just Antakkarana. It has to be Abhasa Sahita Antakkarana. That is the difference between Abhasa Vada definition, which is contrasted with the अवच्छेदवादा अतः एव आभास सहित अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्यम जीवः. Therefore, complete definition of pramata or jiva is what? आभास सहित अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्यम, न तु अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्यम. आभास सहित अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्यम जीवः. आभास सहित अंतकरण उपहित चैतन्यम साक्षी, न तु अंतकरण उपहित चैतन्यम. We have to qualify the Antakkarana also as Abhasa Sahita. It has to have Abhasa. There should be, in other words, there should be Pratibimba formed. It cannot be just Antakkarana. Yadyapi Pakshadvaye api Visheshana Sahita Chaitanyam Jivaha Sa Eva Sansari. So, in both the pakshas, meaning both the vadas, Visheshana Sahita Chaitanyam is Jiva in both vadas. Still, and also samsari. Sa eva samsari cha. So, karta, bhokta, sukhi, dukhi are both Visheshana Sahita Chaitanya. Not upahita Chaitanya. So, Visheshana Sahita, not upadi Sahita Chaitanya. Still, tathapi, विशेष्य भागे चैतन्ये जनन मरणादि संसारो न संभवति. However, विशेष्य भागे, although विशेषणा is there in both पक्षास, विशेष्य which is चैतन्य, विशेषण सहित which is what अंतकरण is विशेषण, so अंतकरण सहित चैतन्य. And what is this सह there? Saha is Visheshanatvina. So Antakkarana is a Visheshana in both cases. However, Chaitanya is not affected. Samsari, who is the Samsari really? This Samsari Bhaga. Samsara is possible. Janana Maranadi Rupa Samsara. What kind of Samsara? Janma Marana and everything that goes in between. Shadvikara. So who becomes the Shadvikara one? Shadvikaras cannot be in the Chaitanya, which is the Visheshya. So, Visheshya Bhage, Visheshya Dale, Samsara na Sambhavati. Why? Janana Marana na Sambhavati. Janana Maranadi na Sambhavati. Ityataha, Janana Maranadi Samsara, Visheshya Chaitanya na Sambhavati. Only possible in Visheshana, but it is not possible in Visheshya. Tasmad Visheshana Matre Samsara Paryavasyati. Therefore, where is the connection? Connection ends, the samsara connection ends with the visheshana. Only visheshana, visheshana matre. Unto the visheshana antakkarana, there is connection of samsara. It terminates there. It does not extend to the visheshya. Sa eva visishta chaitanye pratiyate. However, there is a pratiti of samsara, which is what Tattvadrishti had begun with. While he started questioning after the first round of teaching was over, He says you don't have dukkha, you don't have samsara, you are done. But then tattva drishti is not done. It's not as simple as that. Oh Swami, please tell me, how is it that there is a pratiti of samsara in me? How is it that there is a pratiti of dukkha in me? So vishishta chaitanya pratiyate, samsara pratiyate tu. Although there is no connection, still there is a pratiti. There is an appearance of samsara in chaitanya, which is kutastha, which is my real swarupa. So what happens really, this pratiti? So pratiti is explained here. Kvachid visheshana gata dharmana vyavaharo visishte bhavati. So in the visheshya or the visishta, which has a visheshana, kvachid, in some cases, visheshana gata dharmana vyavaharaha visishte bhavati. So pratiti is there. Even in the language, we talk in that manner. Oh, you know, there is, I have dukkha, I have shoka, I have moha, I have raga. All this is a usage in vyavahara with I, and that I aham, aham sukhi, meaning sukham asya asti iti sukhi. So when I say aham sukhi, then I am saying sukham mama asti. And that mama, when I am saying, I am unable to differentiate between the real kutastha chaitanya me versus the antakkarana me, which is not really me. So kvachit visheshana gata dharmana vyavaharo vishishte bhavati. There is a usage of visheshana dharma, dharma which is in the visheshana. Antakkarana being the visheshana, antakkarana has dharma. Sukha, dukkha, raga, dvesha, tirsha, all these are there in antakkarana. But still, the shoka, moha, ityadi, all these appear in me. So, visishte vyavahara bhavati. Kvachid, elsewhere, visheshya gata dharmanam vyavahara visishte bhavati. The flip side is also there in many places, such as I say that the, you know, my body exists. It is there. You know, anything about the body is there. Satta, which is there, Satta does not belong to the visheshana at all. Antakkarana, Sharira also extended to Sharira, but let's stick to Antakkarana. Antakkarana exists, also is alive. Sukshma Sharira, if you extend it to Sukshma Sharira, entire Sukshma Sharira claims its own existence. It comes to life as though. So sentience is felt, you know, buddhi, I am an intellectual. When I say I am an intellect, the intellect comes alive. It's very sharp, you know. We say that in my mind, there are some things going on. So when you say in my mind, the assumption is that the mind exists and there are things going on. My mind, you know, my mind runs off on its own. When it runs off, it has to exist first. Then runs off means what? It starts running in, not physically, but in thinking. It starts running. My intellect starts running. It just needs an input. It will start to function. It will take the input and run a thread. Multitasking is going on in my intellect. So when it is thinking, it is analyzing, that analysis is going on. It is possible only a sentient entity. Analysis is not possible for a insentient thing, for an insentient thing. For a sentient being, it is possible. Antakkarana, buddhi, all these are insentient. But still, that sentience, as though conscious, you know, that consciousness extends and gives its spurti also. Spurana is the Atma Dharma. Dharma is in Lakshana. It is Swarupa Dharma. Swarupa Dharma is not really Dharma. It is Lakshana, Lakshana Dharma. So that is not a dharma or a property really. It is its nature. Very nature is sentience, consciousness. That manifests in the antakarana by just by the mere presence or proximity, tadatmya sambandha it extends. Even without tadatmya sambandha, some sambandha. Initially, some sambandha is there. So that is explained here as kvachit visheshyagata dharmanam vyavahara visheshte bhavati. So visheshya, visheshyagata dharmanam vyavahara visheshte bhavati. Kvachit visheshana visheshyobhayagata dharmanam vyavahara visheshte bhavati. So there are some places both visheshana and visheshya ubhayagata dharmanam vyavahara visheshte bhavati. I explained the flip side, but here the second is, we'll look at the example given by sadhu. I was just explaining adhyasa, but here, what is vishishta? Vishishta, wherever there is vishishta there, which dharma is having a pratiti there? That has to be seen. The flip side was for the first point, not the second point. Flip side, kvachit visheshana gata dharmana vyavahara vishishte bhavati, but in adhyasa, there is mishri karana on both sides. So I explained the flip side also. Here the sadhu is not dealing with the flip side. He is just talking about visheshana gata dharma in vishishta, visheshya gata dharma in vishishta, visheshana visheshya ubhaya gata dharma in vishishta. So those are the three divisions. And then the explanation given with the example tad yatha. So he has given explanation for all three. Dandena ghatakasho nashyati ityatra visheshani bhuta ghata eva dandena nashyati. When you pick up a stick and break a pot, that time only the pot is really broken by the stick. Visheshani bhuta ghata, the ghata is a visheshana to the ghatakasha. So when danda, using a danda, you are breaking a ghata, you are breaking the visheshani bhuta ghata, natu akasha. Ghata akasha is not having any sambandha at all with the ghata. So when you break the ghata using the danda, that time ghata akasha, you are not breaking the ghata akasha using the danda, but still dandena ghata akasho nashyati. One can say, you know, ghata akasha is no longer there. You cannot have the vyavahara of ghatakasha anymore. The pratiti of ghatakasha was there because of ghata creating a boundary. Without the anvaya in the karya, in ghatakasha, still it was dividing, distinguishing the ghatakasha from the mahakasha. So far it was an upadhi, but still the in the destruction, when the pot is destroyed, ghatakasha is not destroyed. Ghatakasha didn't have a real presence at all. It was all the while akasha. Without being separated from akasha, ghatakasha was just a name. So at most the name was destroyed. Ghatakasha was not destroyed. It did not have a specific presence at all, a differentiated presence. Therefore, dandena ghatakasha nashyati. There it is, nama matra nasha. Ityatra visheshani bhuta ghata eva dandena nashyati natu visheshya bhuta akashaha. Still there is a usage, tathapi visishte ghata akashe. The ghata akasha is visishta. Still visishte ghata akashe nasha pratiti bhavati, pratitaha bhavati. Nashasya pratiti hi bhavati atva nasha pratitaha bhavati. Nasha is pratitaha, meaning there is a pratiti of nasha of ghatakasha, which is visheshta, which has, there is a visheshana here. So that which is differentiated by a differentiating adjective, that differentiated ghatakasha is going to have this nasha pratiti. After the ghata has nasha, there is a pratiti of ghatakasha nasha also. So that is the example of visheshana having sambandha with the vishishta. फर्दर कुंडली पुरुष स्वपीति कुंडली सो कुंडलम अस्य अस्ति इति कुंडली वन हु हैज अ कुंडला एन इयर रिंग सो जनरली इन हिंदू देर इज अ संस्कारा सो वन ऑफ द संस्कारास इज व्हेन द चाइल्ड इज बॉर्न द इयर्स आर पियर्स्ड नाउ दे आर पियर्स्ड एंड यू नो जनरली एज अ किड दे कीप दी फॉर बॉयज आई एम सेइंग फॉर गर्ल्स द इयर रिंग्स रिमेन बट देर आर मेनी हु डू नॉट कीप द इयर रिंग्स दे शुड बी देयर बट देन as the child grows as the specifically the boy grows they you know start dropping it they don't use it the ear may be pierced but the kundala may not be there now how do you differentiate the boy with a kundala and one without the kundala so there kundali purusha swapiti so kundali purusha swapiti there कुंडली कुंडला इज अ विशेषण जस्ट गिव मी वन मोमेंट सो एक्चुअली आई वाज कंफ्यूजिंग माय सेल्फ विद द दिस थिंग हियर इट्स अ ब्रेसलेट सॉरी सो इट्स नॉट अ यू नो कर्ण इंस्ट्रूमेंट इट इज अ कुंडली इज अ ब्रेसलेट सो Kundali Purusha. So it's a Kundali is actually something which is round. So here, but really it is that which is a bracelet. So break, you know, either way you take it, it is not important. Whatever is a Kundala, Kundalam Asya Asti Iti Kundali. That happens to be this Purusha when grown up. So a Purusha Swapiti is sleeping. When you say who is sleeping, the one who has Kundala is sleeping. Ityatra Visheshana is Kundala. So Visheshane Kundale. स्वापो न अन्वेति देयर इज नो अन्वय ऑफ द स्वपन क्रिया द स्लीपिंग क्रिया हैज नथिंग टू डू विद द कुंडल इट इज ओनली हैविंग अन्वय विद पुरुष पुरुष स्वपीति न तो कुंडलम सो कुंडले विशेषणे स्वापो न अन्वेति ऑब्वियसली द क्रिया इट इज नॉट दैट द कुंडल इज स्लीपिंग विशेषे पुरुषे तु स्वाप संभवति Only in Visheshya Purusha there is Swapa. Tathapi Kundala Vishishta Swapiti iti Vishishte Swapa Vyavaharo Bhavati. However, when you say Kundala Vishishta Swapiti, one who has Kundala, that kind of a Purusha. So, Purusha is no longer there in the sentence. Kundala Vishishta Swapiti. There, Vishishte iti Vishishte Swapa Vyavaharo Bhavati. Where is the swapa vyavahara? It is in the purusha. Who is vishishta? With kundala visheshana. So there vishishte. So that's why purusha is what? Is visheshya. When you have a visheshana, kundala is a visheshana for purusha. That time purusha is called as visheshya. But when you replace the word purusha with vishishta, then it is clear that vishishta. Who is vishishta? Purusha. And this visheshya which has kriya is appearing in the visheshta, not in the kundala. So this is an example. It's a little tricky to see the difference between one and two. But then the words which are used, if you understand this visheshya, visheshta with pratyas, krut pratyas, then it is clear. It's a little technical. But anyway, as long as you understand the example, it is fine. कुंडल विशिष्ट स्वपीति इति विशिष्टे स्वाप व्यवहारो भवति सॉरी आयुध पाणि पुरुषः योद्धुं याति इन द सेंटेंस याति गोज हु गोज पुरुष सो पर्सन अ सोल्जर इज गोइंग टू फाइट योद्धुं याति ही गोज टू फाइट अ बैटल देयर आयुध पाणि ही व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ पुरुष ही हैज अ विशेषण ऑफ being having an ayuda a weapon so ayuda panihi is a bahuri ayuda pano yasya saha purusha ayuda panihi so one who has a weapon in his hand or hands if you take two he has a weapon then we'll say in one hand otherwise we can say in two hands also if they have multiple weapons. So ayudha pani hi purushaha, one who has is carrying a weapon rather. In simpler words, a person who is carrying a weapon in his hand, that person is going to fight. So he is going to a battle. Ityatra visheshanasya ayudhasya. The ayudha weapon is a visheshana. Visheshanasya ayudhasya. Visheshasya purushasya cha yuddhaya gamanat ubhayaropi dharma visishte vyavahriyate. So vyavahara is there in the visishta. Ayudha panihi purushaha yodhum yati ityatra. Visheshanasya ayudhasya. So ayudha is a visheshana and vishesha is the purusha. Both of them, yuddhaya visheshasya purushasya visheshanasya ayudhasya cha. So both of them, yuddhaya gamanad. There is a yodhum yati in there. Ya is prapane. Ya prapane. There is a gamana. Gamanartha. So in the yati kriya, what kind of a yati kriya? Yodhum yati kriya. Of the kriya of going to yuddha, yuddhaya gamanad, ubhayorapi dharma vishishte vyavahriyate. There is a vyavahara of what? Ubhayorapi dharma vishishte vyavahriyate. Ubhayorapi. So vishishte, there is a connection of both. So anyway, we have seen what is the idea there. Sometimes you have visheshanagata dharma appearing in visheshta. Appearing, that is why there is a vyavahara. Or just by words, we make such sentences. If you analyze further, then you will know what has a connection with what. And how it doesn't have the connection with the other, but still there is a vyavahara. So it is used loosely without inquiry. If you inquire, then you will know as to what has sambandha with what. So pravesha kutra asti, pravesha kutra nasti. That has to be understood. This is the takeaway here. Whenever you look at the dharmas, in the examples, the vyavahara is there and we don't need to inquire much. But if the example is understood as to which has a connection with what and which does not have a connection with what, then the same can be extended in the exemplified. Exemplified being kutastha chaitanye kasyapi sambandha asti vanava. Visheshana antakkarana and antakkarana gata dharma, are they having any connection with me really or not? That is the idea with which all these have been brought about. So prakrute, in the context, prakrute tu avachheda vade antakkaranam visheshanam, abhasa vade abhasa sahita antakkaranam visheshanam. This is the differentiation we have seen. Antakkarana visishta chaitanyam pramata. This is true with both, but still there is an additional qualification in abhasavada, which is abhasa sahita antakkaranam is visheshana. So abhasa sahita antakkarana visishta chaitanyam pramata. Dvayorapi pakshayosh chaitanyam visheshyam. So which is the qualified there? Chaitanya. Visheshya is chaitanya. So that chaitanya which has a visheshana of antakkarana is common in both avachhedavada as well as abhasavada. Chaitanya remains as visheshya in both. So that is also common. Tasminsh chaitanye janmadi samsaro na sambhavati. This is also common in both vadas. In the chaitanya, samsara cannot be there, which is janma marana rupa. Kintu visheshanasya antakkaranasya va abhasa sahita antakkaranasya va dharma bhutaha yaha janvadi rupa samsaraha saha aviveki bhihi bhrantya visishta chaitanye vyavahriyate. So by avivekis, when they make a usage that, oh, I was born on this day, I celebrate my birthday and someday I am going to die. Therefore, janamadi samsara, the entire set of vikaras which are going on. You know, I am growing old. You know, I was quite young during those days. And then extending, I had a great memory. Now it's failing. No, but I still, you know, I am keeping fit. All these ideas which are there, all those vikaras there are there in the Shariratraya. Mostly seen in the stool and sukshma shariras. Currently, we are focused only on antakarana, which is part of the sukshma sharira. The stula sharira connection comes afterwards. Afterwards, in the sense, only when antakarana is connected. Layering after layering is possible only when the inner layer is worn, then you can wear the outer layer. So, antakarana is the inner layer. So, that is being analyzed, and in antakarana, antakarana which plays the role of buddhi, that is the first, you know, first cause to individualize and bind. Therefore, antakarana is being looked at into how the Brahma Chaitanya becomes Pramatra Chaitanya, individualized. So, tasmin chaitanye janamadi samsaro na sambhavati kintu visheshanasya antakaranasya va abhasa sahita antakaranasya va dharma bhutaya janamadi rupa samsara. That janamadi bhuta samsara, janamadi rupa samsara, which is a dharma for the antakarana. Which antakarana? Either the antakarana, which is visheshana in the avachyedavada, or antakarana, which is abhasa sahita antakarana in the abhasa vada. That samsara saha avyuveki bhi bhrantya, due to bhranti, which is vikshepa, due to avarana being there. So, avidya causes, avidya or ajnana causes avarana of swarupa, and after swarupa avarana, there is a bhranti due to vikshepa. Therefore, viveki bhi bhrantya vishishta chaitanya vyavahriyate. Janmadi rupa samsara is not there in the vishishta chaitanya, only in visheshana antakarana, which is abhasa sahita, specifically more qualified, granularized in the abhasa vada. There alone, there is janmadi rupa samsara, but it is used by aviveki with respect to one's own real swarupa, kutastha chaitanya, vishishta chaitanya, which happens to be kutastha. Vyavaharo nama pratitihi kathanancha. What is vyavahara? You keep on mentioning vyavahara, vyavahara. So he clarifies that also. Vyavahara is nothing but pratiti and kathanam. Pratiti, an appearance. It appears in me and I talk about it in such a manner. I say that, oh, I have dukkha. Why? It appears to me you don't know about my dukkha. I have anubhava of dukkha. What do you know about it? So I have an appearance of dukkha in me and I talk about it in such a manner. That is vyavahara. Anaya rithya abhasa vada avachyeda vada yor bhedo avagantavya. So in this manner, we have to understand the difference between abhasa vada and avachyeda vada. Currently only difference which is mentioned is abhasa sahita is the qualification for antakarana in the abhasa vada. Otherwise, antakarana being a visheshana is common in the avachyeda vada also. Now, this abhasa vadasya jayastvam. Abhasa vada is superior to avachyeda vada. Why so is explained in the 216th avarta. We'll look at it in the next part. Sukham nityam saprakasham vyapakam namarupe adhishtanam buddhyabodhyam buddhirdrukyatna nirmanam aparam sarvevedanta vedyam pratyak paramah tadevahanamakyam iti me nishchita matihi. Jatsat. Namaskara. I'll see you in the next part.
Haribom.